Let's talk about the worst shock that I've ever received. The worst shock. There's been a few. So I need to preface this by saying it's not good ever to work on live circuits. I've learned that through trial by fire over the years and coming across people that had different messaging than what I was brought up through. When I was brought up in the industry, there wasn't a whole lot of safety. It was just a lot of machismo, a lot of like, just get it done. Like, stop being a wuss, just do it. And so I wasn't trained with safety as like the important thing. When there was something that was like unsafe, master electrician would be like, hey, don't touch that, I'll touch it. And you know, like that was probably the most of it. I learned you're blowing up a pair of clients and then having to go spend money. But, oh, like you need to check the Romex before you cut it. Lots of dumb things like that. And I learned what to touch and what not to touch, again, the hard way. And I started going into groups and forums and stuff online, and I started hearing about this whole safety thing. And then as I was studying code, I would like come across the 70E, you know, electrical safety, and start reading stuff. And I'm like, what's this lockout tagout business? You know what I mean? So like, that's not good. If you're out there running a company this way and you got people and this is how you're going about it, stop doing that. It's your job to train people, to keep them safe so that they can go home and see their families at the end of the day. Anyways, all right, now let's get into my stupid shocks. I think the story under the house is probably the best story. So I was in the trade for, I don't know, maybe like 3 years at this point, 2 years, something like that. It was right around the point where I got my residential wireman's license. And I think even maybe before it, this was like a side job kind of thing. I've done videos on why you shouldn't be doing side jobs as well, if you want to watch that. I think this job, I was out in the middle of nowhere. So this was out in Fayetteville, Texas, which is the middle of nothing, nowhere. Lots of open Texas land with no houses anywhere. And I was on this house that was a pier and beam house, which just means it's kind of like it's a house on stilts. So you crawl under the house to work on stuff. And most of the wiring was done under the house where they would drill holes and push wires up. And that's how they wired it rather than going up into an attic. So I was under the house. It had been raining for days. On this particular day, it wasn't raining anymore, but the ground was super saturated and wet. So one thing you have to understand about electrical current is the only way to slow current down, it's not really slowing it, but the only way to like manage the amount of current going through something is by adding resistance to a circuit. If there's very little resistance, a whole lot of amperes are gonna flow. If there's a whole lot of resistance, not very much is gonna flow. Your skin, the human body, actually offers a certain amount of resistance to electrical current depending on where you're getting shocked. If you moisten the skin and make it wet, it's a much better conductor. So it offers less resistance to current flow, so more current will flow through any given point. And it's always very important for you to be cautious of where you're getting shocked from. You're never gonna get shocked by like touching a thing. You always get shocked from touching two things. So current is flowing in a complete loop from the source through your body and back. And so I just didn't know all of these things, right? I'm just out here doing side work, trying to get money. So the ground was wet. I'm wet, sweating profusely underneath this house in the middle of Texas, you know, summer. In this particular situation, I was laying on my back in the mud and working above my head. And again, laying on the dirt, I got maybe, I don't know, like 18 inches worth of space between me and the floor people stand on. And there was a junction box under there. And I remember going and I didn't have a good tester, the little tick tracer I was using, the little dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. It was one of those things where it sat in my truck in the back and got rained on. It's like sometimes it worked, sometimes it didn't work. Sometimes it made really crazy noises. Other times it didn't make any noises, but it lit up. I didn't know what I was doing. I kinda knew, but I was just like hacking this to try to get through it. And that's always when you get hurt. And so I was under here messing with this junction box and I pulled my little sniffer out and I didn't hear anything on this wire. So I just assumed it was off. And so I'm like, all right, open up the junction box. There's wires in there. And I stick my hand in and boom, immediately get hit. I'm like, fuck. And it hurt because I was wet and my arm was touching the ground and my hand was touching the shaft of a tool or whatever the hell even happened. I don't even remember what happened, but I do remember just getting shocked. So I crawl out and go over to the panel, start trying to flip breakers. I'm there by myself. There's no homeowner, there's nothing. I'm just middle of nowhere. And they had a huge panel. It was probably like a 42 circuit panel with every slot taken up. And so I'm sitting there flipping breakers, trying to listen for this thing, and it just keeps falling down on the ground. So I have to go back under there and put my ticker back up and try to balance it. And eventually I just heard it go off. And I didn't realize that it had just slightly moved. So when I got back over there, I was like, all right, cool, circuit's off. Get under there, and I start taking all the wires out. And dude, that I took one wire out, and I guess it was the hot one. Breaker didn't shut off. I had the wrong breaker. And that thing, I got shocked at this on my fingertip. And so I just felt this buzz. Well, I'm laying under the fucking wire. And so it drops on my chest and hits me and my body bounces. And it just went right through me and it hit me right where my heart is, you know? So like, I'm fortunate that I didn't die from this, but it hit me and then it laid on me and I'm sitting there like, no, nah! Like actually making audible noises, not trying to, just that's what's coming out. And I grabbed the wire and I push it up and it fell down again and it just kept going boom and hitting me, shocking the shit out of me. And finally I just fucking tucked and rolled and got out of there. And I sat there. This hurt bad. This is the worst like pain of a shock that I'd ever experienced before. Like it went through my skeletal system, you know, like I felt it on every level because I was soaking wet. And so it was just like, I felt like I just had a spider web of electricity just come over me. And I'm filthy and just sweaty and it's hot as shit. And I just can't believe that I did what I did. And I thought that I should have died. And that started to mess with my head. And so I just said, after I caught my breath, I was like, you know what? Fuck this shit. Like, dude, I'll go wait tables. This is not worth $25 an hour for me, for that hour I was under there, for me to like almost kill myself for $25. Fuck that shit, I'm done. This electrician shit's for the birds. So I grab all my stuff, I'm all pissed off, go over to my truck, just fucking throw everything into the back of it, slam the tailgate, get up, and I take off. I didn't call the homeowner, I didn't say shit, I was just like, fuck this. And it was like an hour and a half, 2 hours away from my house. So like, not only was it not like a job local, it was something that I had to like drive forever to get to. And I'm driving down the road and I start thinking, right? Like, I love this. And I've never loved anything. I've done more jobs than the average person because I've just had it. I've been a single dad since I was 18. Had to have 2-3 jobs at a time because when you're making 15 an hour, quarter comes out for government, for taxes, quarter comes out for baby's mama. So that's 750 an hour that you're bringing home. And 40 hours a week at 750 an hour is not shit when you're trying to pay for your own place to live. You ain't got anybody there helping you, roommates, anything like that. So like being broke, man, that was my story for so long. So I've just had to have a lot of different jobs. And there's no job I've ever had other than this, other than this electrical thing that I've actually loved. And so I started thinking about it and I'm like, am I being a bitch right now? You know, like, am I just giving up on something because it's easy and I'm pissed off? And so I probably got like a mile or two down the road and I pull over and I stop. And I sat there and I was just started hitting the fucking steering wheel and being like, fuck, 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 fuck. Like I was so, so angry. And I have a kid, you know, and like that started to fuck with me too. And I'm like, I could have just orphaned my kid under this house being stupid. And then I realized this is my fault. This isn't electricity's fault. It's reliable, it does what it does, right? This was my stupid fucking fault that I allowed myself to be in a position like this, to not know something, to just be trying to do janky shit just to make some money. And at that moment, I realized I haven't mastered this thing that I love and I'm letting it master me and it's in control and I'm not, and that needs to change. So for me to get to a point where I feel mastery at this craft that I'm fucking in love with, I need to go back and finish. And if only because my word is my fucking bond in life in general. Y'all know that about me. When I fucking say a thing, I mean it. And when I say I'm gonna show up and I'm gonna follow through with something, I fucking do it. And so I'm not gonna go call this customer and be like, hey, sorry, I shocked myself and I'm just done. Nah, man. I'm gonna go back to the job. I'm gonna finish the job. I'm gonna turn every fucking breaker in that whole house off in a fit, in a rage. But I'm gonna finish this job and I'm gonna follow through and show up for what I said I was gonna do. So I did. I went back, took a long breath. I think I kicked my tire, maybe kicked my truck a few times because I was so fucking mad at myself. And that's the thing, right? Like, I'm harder on myself than anybody can be in comments, or I don't give a shit about any of that. I'm fucking brutal in my own head from time to time. Or I was, I used to be. I think I'm doing pretty all right. I'm like proud of myself and happy of where I'm at. I've got that like inner confidence now. So I get back and crawl under there. And I shut every breaker in the house off. And I get back under there and I put everything back together, run the wire, do whatever I was supposed to do. It was like the last task of the day. So I was already done with everything else. So I just did what I had to do and finished it and thought the entire time about how fucking stupid I was to have gotten myself into that situation. And how easily just trying to do something half-assed and not really care and not be cautious and take some extra precaution to ward off the risk, how stupid that was. And I'm here to tell you, y'all watch these videos of me and electrician you, and you think that I am like this super electrician. People tell me that shit. And I'll write in the comments, he's the GOAT, he knows more than, I don't. I actually don't know more than everybody. And I'm not the best electrician out there. I still fuck up, you know? Like, as a master, my job is now, instead of trying to not fuck up, my job is to try to fuck up. You know what I mean? Like, my role is like, I should be perfecting what I'm doing so much that I need to be looking for the ways in which I fuck up, because it's far less than it was when I was, you know, younger. When you're an apprentice, you're fucking up everything, right? So you're looking for those moments when you do something perfect. As a master, it's like you should try to perfect your craft and your method of your craft so much that your blindsides are few and far between. And then having conversations with people that do know more than you. It's like every master has a master. So like, I love when I do something or I explain something in a way where I said something wrong or I understood something wrong or an analogy that I used to explain something was like way inaccurate. I love that shit. I actually love getting feedback from people because it's only in those moments that I realize I can learn something. And once I've been wrong, and now I know a thing, now I can be right for fucking ever. You know what I mean? So I actually like being wrong. I like making mistakes and learning from that. So anyways, one thing I have to finish on is if you are working in an environment where people are not practicing safety, I know, right? The thing to do is like shit on the safety guy. If you're working at a big high rise, you got like 500 people with like, you know, brand new clean hard hats that have never even seen a wall, have never been scratched, no stickers on them from all the different job sites they've been on. They got their safety glasses and their clipboard and their fresh pressed little blue vest or whatever the fuck. It's hard to respect them, right? Because they're telling you to wear your hard hat when you're in a hole this big and you can't fit your hard hat. There's some dumb shit out there, yes. And so safety gets a bad rap because some of the people that are trying to tell you to be safe have no clue what they're talking about. They're just like hired, paid a bunch of money because they got some fucking degree, and they're up your ass about all this shit, this liability shit with insurance companies. You know, it's like, I understand the lack of respect in that environment because I've done high rises, I've been in those environments. Aside from that, okay, the disrespecting that, I understand. To be a master of your craft, you have to take ownership. You have an obligation now that you can't just be somebody that shows up and takes a paycheck home. Now, the wealth of knowledge that you have and the amount of impact that you have on an environment commands that you take your reach seriously and you think about the impact of your decisions. So now you have to care more. The people under you and around you, now it's your responsibility. You sit in court with a judge and some kid got electrocuted on your job and you're a master and you've got that master card, they're gonna grill the fuck out of you. It's your job to have made sure that they go home at the end of the day. So there's a lot of liability and seriousness with which to take your role. It's the other half of what we do. We don't just pull wires like these mindless wire monkeys jumping around pulling wires through holes. There's a lot to know. With the amount of seriousness you take the electrical code to understand how to install things so that people don't die and equipment doesn't burn up, buildings don't set on fire, with that same level of seriousness, you need to understand safety. This shit can kill you easily. People are like, oh, 120 volts isn't gonna kill you. Bro, 120 volts, depending on the situation, I could have fucking died. That was a 120 volt piece of 12-2 Romex that fell on my chest, fell on my heart, through moist water on the ground. I should have died. But whatever the value of resistance was that I was offering to, you know, the current that was traveling through me, it wasn't enough. I can't stress this enough. People gaff off safety. What we do, you need to take with deadly seriousness. I always say, like in life, don't take yourself so seriously, but take what you do with deadly seriousness. I'm getting philosophical here with you, and I promise I'll wrap this shit up. Life's like a game, right? There's levels to this shit, and there's problems, constantly new problems, knocking on your fucking door your whole life, always just knocking, knocking, knocking. And as soon as you solve and figure out a problem and you're like, ugh, I'm great, boom, you get hit with another problem. Somebody smashes your car, whatever. Life is problems, and it's like a game. It's a puzzle for us to sit and figure out our way through all of these different problems. Funny enough, a lesson seems to repeat itself over and over and over until you finally learn it. And then once you're done learning it, problem doesn't come up anymore. You know, or if it does, you just handle it differently, so it's really not a problem now. But the more advanced players of a game, they start studying the game as a whole, and they start mastering the entire thing because now they have a 30,000 foot view of the whole thing. And for you to ever be top notch, super all-star baller electrician, best of the best electrician, you have to know how electricity works. You have to delve into the science of it. You have to know what PPE is, when you can work on things live, when not to. You need to understand what lockout tagout means and how lock boxes work and how to make sure that all of your people go home at the end of the day. If you're gonna take this shit that serious, be good at it. Don't be out here fronting like you're fucking good when you really are terrible and you're making stupid decisions and you're fucking endangering other people's lives. Don't do that shit. Take this shit serious. Anyways, enough of my rant. I love you crazy fuckers. Please be safe out there. Take this shit seriously. Safeguard the people around you. Safeguard yourself. And always, always, always be a craftsman and a student. Don't think that you're at the top level and you know more than everybody. That's some childish bullshit right there. Always act like a student. Always take what you do with deadly fucking seriousness. Do good every day. Try to impress yourself every fucking day of your career. And you'll get there. Love you. Bye.